There's a story in the Bible that relates to a lot of us today as we have faced the storm of this pandemic. In Mark 4, Jesus has just finished a busy day of ministry, and he tells his disciples to get into the boat, and I want you to go to the other side of the lake. So they all jump in, and Jesus lays down for a little nap. But on the way to the other side, a fierce storm comes over the lake, so fierce that the disciples are scared for their very lives. They're sure the boat's gonna go down, and they're gonna go down with it, and they're gonna drown. But what does Jesus do? Does he jump up from his nap in a panic, grab a bucket, and start frantically bailing water? Does he yell to Peter, "Turn around, go back"? Or does he abandon ship and leave the disciples to their own fate? Nope, none of these. If you know the story, you know that he keeps on sleeping. Now, if you're like me, you've probably wondered, Jesus, how in the world is it even possible for you to sleep in a storm like that? I can barely sleep with a storm knocking a tree branch against my window, let alone knocking me back and forth in a ship. Don't you know the disciples were wondering the same thing? As a matter of fact, they yelled to him, Jesus, don't you care if we drowned? When Jesus didn't act, the disciples questioned his concern for them. Are you questioning his concern for you today? Maybe not out loud, but maybe in your heart. Jesus, don't you care what I'm going through? Don't you see the doctor's report? Don't you care what I'm facing right now with my kid? Were you just asleep when I lost my job? Maybe you are a lot like me, and maybe you've yelled maybe once or twice, hey, Jesus, wake up. But you see, Jesus wasn't oblivious to the storm his disciples were in. He had not turned a deaf ear to their cries. No, of course not, because he loved them. The storm simply presented an opportunity to all of them. They all had the same choice of how to handle the storm. And in that moment, the disciples panicked and Jesus rested. I think Jesus was able to rest peacefully in the midst of that storm and that turmoil because he knew something that's important for us to remember today. The ship wasn't going down if he was on it. No matter how much the wind howled or the waves crashed or the thunder threatened, it couldn't take Jesus down or those who were in his care. Jesus had said they were going to the other side, and no storm was gonna stop that. When we are with Jesus, we won't go down either. You know, in an age of intense stress and anxiety, many people have difficulty sleeping. Maybe you're one of them. We often receive prayer requests here at TBN from people who toss and turn all night, or they wake up with panic attacks over concerns that they just can't shake. It's tempting to panic when life throws something at you that you weren't expecting. This pandemic, the loss of a job, a sickness, a betrayal, the death of a loved one or a child who goes astray. Our first instinct is to fight or flight or just freeze. But when Jesus faced with those options, he chose none of those. Instead, he chose to rest. You know, I love this beautiful promise in Psalms 4:8. It says, "In peace I will lie down and sleep. For you alone, O Lord, will keep me safe." We too can rest in the storm when we know that Jesus is with us. We don't have to strive or stress or panic. Nope, we can rest. He will take us to the other side. The boat was simply a means of getting from one place to another. Jesus never promised that they wouldn't encounter rough waters. The storm was just a part of their journey. And in the end, it served as a catalyst for an important lesson. When Jesus wakes up and he calms the storm, the disciples see the ultimate example of rest. The storm did not impact Jesus. Rather, from a place of rest, Jesus impacted the storm. My friend, no matter what you're walking through right now, I want you to know that Jesus is with you. He said, "Come to me, all you who are under heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." He has not turned a deaf ear to your cry. He is not asleep out of negligence or apathy. No, He's aware of the storms in your life. He invites you to a place of rest in Him. In Philippians 4, 6, and 7, it says, "Be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your heart and your minds through Christ Jesus." God invites us to lay down our worries and our anxieties and instead enter into that beautiful place of rest. A rest that isn't untouched by storms, but a rest that storms can't take from us. A rest that comes from knowing that Jesus is in the boat with us and He is navigating us safely to the other side. Because my friend, what waits on the other side is so important. Often our greatest breakthrough, our greatest revelations, or our greatest ministry is waiting on the other side of our biggest storm. You know, the disciples brought Jesus to the lost people on the other side of the lake. Amazing ministry and life-changing miracles took place there. The storm paled in comparison to the salvations that came after. So as we go through this storm, I want to encourage you, keep going. You're not alone. You got to trust that. With Jesus, you will get through this. He has not forgotten you. He is not ignoring you. He is with you, and you can rest in that truth because with Him, you will get to the other side.